Hello and welcome to Umbraco Learning Base. Jonathan here. In this video, we are going to take a look at how you can query your content in templates in Umbraco using the built-in query builder. Great, let's get started. Okay, as you can see, I'm currently in my Umbraco template over here. And as you can see down here, we want to query the blog posts for our website. Awesome. To do so, we can go up to the query builder over here in the Umbraco template. And when we click on it, we get this nice overview of the query builder where we can build our queries for our template here. The first thing that we want to do is we want to decide which content we want to query. In this case, we don't want to query all our content. Instead, we want to query the content of type blog item. So we click on it here. And we decide from where on our website we want to query it. And in this case, we of course want to query it from the blog here. And as we see, we have some blog items underneath. So let's go back and click on blog here. Awesome. And then we can also decide how we want to order our query. We can order it by the created date, the ID, the last update date, or the name. In this case, let's order it by the created date. And let's have it as a descending. Great. So now we can go ahead and look down here where we can see the output of our query in C#. So now let's go ahead and submit our query. Awesome. If we scroll down a bit, we can see that we have our query down here. And it also creates an unordered list with a for each statement, which has a list inside it with an A tag as well. Awesome. So far, so good. Okay, the next step is that we want to incorporate our query over here into our DO down here. Okay, so the first thing that we need to do is that we need to move the for each statement from here down below under the DO class row. So let's move it down below like this. Add it here, and let's just move this forward a bit, and then let's take the closing tag from here as well and add it down below here. Awesome. So far so good. Let's just remove the unordered list tags here and also the list tags as well, as we won't be needing those in this tutorial. Great. So now we have the A tag left up here, and we just need to move that down below to the empty A tag that we have in our DO down here. So let's move it here and take the item name and move it down below here to the H5 tag. Awesome. We can just remove this part over here and let's go ahead and save it. Awesome. Now let's take a quick look at the front end to see how it looks like. Great. So let's go up here as I have already opened up the page. Let's just refresh the page down here and let's take a look. If we go down, we can see that it is indeed displaying our blog items down here. Awesome. So far, so good. However, it doesn't really look super nice just yet, as it kind of feels like something is missing, like some images or something. So let's just do some small things before we end this video. So what we need to do is that we need to add a bit of code snippet down under our for each statement here. So we add this var thumbnail equal item.value ipublish content thumbnail image. And then we also need to add the thumbnail URL. And this we do in the DO class called thumbnail-image. And we add it in the style here specifically. Awesome. Let's go ahead and save it. And let's take a look at our front end. Let's refresh it here. And awesome. As you can see, it's now displaying our images as well. Great. That is all that I have for you in this video. My name is Jonathan, and I'll see you in the next one. Jonathan out.